Yo, what is up? Today's video that I have for you, I got three tips that will help you improve your game immediately, today, now, pronto. Now, obviously, this game has been around for a long time. This game has a lot of nuances, has a lot of things you need to learn to improve your game. You know, you've got to learn so many things. View range skills, armor skills, penetration skills, a lot of things you need to learn about this game. Obviously, there's so many things, but I wanted to narrow it down to three things that you can use immediately, three things that you can implement right now and improve today, and that this will carry you on for the rest of your World of Tanks gaming career. So three tips that are massively important, and in my opinion, the most important thing, and that gonna provide you the biggest impact for the longest period of time. So let's kick off this video with the first tip, which is map awareness. Keep one eye on the map. This is the first skill you must master and constantly update. You have to train your brain to work like a computer when deciphering movements on the map. Now every tip video you watch, they're gonna tell you about this map awareness. So keep this in mind. Use the plus minus key to make your map bigger. This helps a lot. You know, if you're new, if you need help keeping focus and learning to apply this skill, incorporate it into your game. You know, after some time, you might find yourself improved and better versed, and that's when maybe you can reduce the size of the map, you know, make it smaller. If immersion is your thing, if that's important to you, you know, after some time, then you can lower that, make that map a little bit smaller. If you constantly practice to improve your map reading skills, you will be able to literally look into the future and be able to prepare and influence the game with your insight or your premonition ability. Map awareness over time helps you predict where everyone will initially deploy in the early part of the game. It will, you know, over time, it will help you improve your natural spider sense when you are making critical decisions. When you are processing information in real time, you know, in the fog of war, your ability to read the future of the map will help you stay two steps ahead of your enemies. When you are a master of the minimap, you can make blind shots into bushes and even earn some free damages there. You know, if you watch all your favorite streamers, YouTubers, good players, you'll notice how often they can call out the movement of their targets or their enemies. You know, almost all the time they are correct. Obviously, they're not always 100% correct all the time, and they will, you know, even readily admit that, you know, when that is happening, you know, when they fail to call out a play, they know. But the idea of map awareness isn't about trying to be perfect or trying to be correct 100% of the time, but constantly building experience through map awareness means you are going to be better at predicting the movements of your enemies and your teammates, and you can use this to your advantage. So the first tip, map awareness, work hard at it and keep working at it all the time. Now the second tip that I have for you is quite a controversial one, and not a lot of people are going to say this, but I'm going to say this because I think you can definitely improve immediately with this skill, and this skill is the tracking skill. One of the most underrated skills that you can learn in the game, But in my opinion, one of the most important skills that you can make, you know, you can learn it and you can make a significant impact in your scores and your results, you know, instantly, right now, today. If you implement it, you will see the difference right now. You will see the difference today. If you started focusing on tracking today or right now, you will see a significant improvement right away. It will definitely be responsible for taking your game up a few levels, up a few notches. Why tracking? Tracking does a few things. So let me break it down for you so you understand the importance of mastering this skill. Tracking immobilizes your enemy, right? It forces your enemy to use the repair kit, which will be on cooldown for the next 90 seconds after they've used it. Now, during tracking, you and your teammates can shoot at the helpless enemy, right? You're gonna earn damage because you damage your enemy while they're being tracked. And you can also earn assisted damage because your teammates are shooting the guy that you track, which adds up to your overall combat experience, because you get combat experience from the damage you do, and you get combat experience from the damage your teammates do from, you know, from your job tracking the enemy. So this is really important because you will definitely earn more XP. You will get to kill your enemies quicker, and this is very important if you want to win the game, right? And when you track an enemy, you also learn how skilled or how experienced that enemy is. You figure out how good the other player is by how they react to your tracking shots. For example, okay, if you track an enemy, they repair, retreat to safety, and then continue to engage you without properly protecting themselves, immediately you know, oh, this guy is inexperienced and you can probably push him. Plus, they are now on repairs cooldown. They cannot afford to be tracked again. And then, you know, this is added pressure on them. You can probably pressure them more and win that fight. On another scenario, you track your enemy. They repair and retreat to safety and you never see them again. You can almost guarantee that those players are the inexperienced players. They get tracked, they immediately retreat and run away and they hide and you never see them again. You can assume immediately that you have an option to push them even further. Now, another scenario, the third scenario, you track the enemy, they repair, they retreat to safety, but they continue to keep you spotted, keep you engaged while protecting themselves, you know, using some rubble to protect their lower plate or side scraping, or using their gun to block their cupola. In this situation, you know you are dealing with a seasoned player, and you know they have this knowledge, and with that you can make, you know, better informed decisions. Should I engage? Should I disengage? Egress, run away? Should I zerg rush with my enemy team? You know, with this information, when you track somebody, you can gain information out of that situation. Now, the final and third tip that I have for you, very straightforward, very obvious: do damage. Duh, obviously, you're playing this game, you want to do damage. But what do I mean when I say do damage? What I mean is prioritize damage over our desire to win. Sounds easy, but it's actually quite hard. This is because as humans, we are hardwired to win. It's innate to our nature. We were born, you know, we were born winners. We were born to win. As a sperm, we had to beat millions of other sperms to fertilize the egg. So when you play tanks, you have a natural desire to win. So in order to change this way of thinking, we have to actively convince our brains that doing damage is more important than winning. Now, this is not a secret. All the top players with the highest win rates share this same mentality. The sooner you realize this and implement this to your game strategy, the quicker you will improve your actual win rate. The logic is simple. The more damage you do, the greater your influence is to the team, and the higher your contribution to the chances of winning the game is. From a personal perspective, I can tell you I went through this phase as a beginner myself in 2012. My win rate was 45%. And my focus was only to win. Now, I could maintain a 55% win rate as I improved my gameplay, but I struggled to break 60% win rate. When I switched my mentality to from the win focus to the damage focus, my win rate shot up 60% and above easily. And my survival rate also increased significantly. Switching to damage focus also relieved a lot of stress from me and stopped me from, you know, blaming my teammates when we lost games, losing games. You know, it didn't matter to me anymore because I was only focused on doing damage. When I changed my focus, I was no longer upset about losing, and my win rate improved organically without any effort. Now, this third tip that I say, do damage mentality, it is only applicable to random battles. Keep this in mind and be cognizant of it, because it's totally opposite when you are in a team event. When you're playing Clan Wars Advances, when you're playing with your clan, it is a completely different mentality. The third tip, do damage mentality, has to go out the window, because in a team event, in tournaments where you're working together as a group, you cannot just focus on doing damage for yourself. You need to work together as a team. Even if you did zero damage, but your team won the game, that's the most important thing. So remember, you need to separate yourself when you're playing in tournaments, events. Doing damage is not the priority. This is why there is a lot of difference between players that focus on random battles and players that focus on team battles. Your brain needs to change slightly the way you think about approaching the combat strategy. So when you are playing random battles, when you're on your own, doing damage is your priority. But when you're playing team battles, tournaments, clan wars, advances, think about working together, and winning is your goal. So remember, these two game modes are different. Playing as a team and playing as an individual is very different. Now, obviously, there are a lot of skills you need to learn in order to play this game well, right? You need to know about view range, you need to know about armor, you need to know about camouflage. There's a lot of things you need to learn, but these are the three things that is, in my opinion, the most important things that you can learn, which you can apply immediately right away, and you will see a change in your win rates, and your opportunities to win will improve significantly the better you execute, the better you learn these techniques, and, you know, change your mindset slightly. These skills, or these three tips, will definitely help you improve. And if you can start doing it today, right now, you will immediately see some changes and improvements. Now, I hope you enjoyed these three tips. I wanted to make it really simple, really clean. Three simple tips that you can do right now that will help you, you know, go to the next level, improve your win rates. This is a great game from the Burrasque, the highest damage that I've seen in the Burrasque so far. I hope you enjoyed this video and these three tips, and I will see you on the next video. Let me know what you think. Bye-bye.